Welcome back to Fandom On Demand. Last time on our show, Michael Myers killed some people, Lynn Martha lied about her name, the boys got on a cruise, eventually, and Kitty likes everyone more than Ed Begley Jr. It was riveting stuff. Now, back to our show. So the captain's still dead.
He's dead.
Yeah, we got that. They can't call for help because the bad guys are on to them, so they go hide out in Nellen's room. I tried to sleep in the chair? That's a little unfair. Oh, never mind, they switched off. It's okay. The next morning, the engine suddenly stops, and the bad guys are joined by another bad guy.
It's Crazy Joey Fortune.
Yeah, whatever, I'm sure he's super infamous and dangerous and stuff. Just in case we forgot, Kitty was promiscuous. Thanks, Joe! They go snooping in on the bad guys, but they're interrupted by Nellen, who takes a shot at Joey from the other side. This gets all three of them captured. Turns out Nellen was just out for revenge on Joey the whole time because he killed her father, who we've never heard of until this moment. Super payoff.
Wait. Alright. Listen, if it means anything to you. We both respected your father a great deal. Admired him for the way he stood up to Fortune.
If you felt that way, then why'd you stop me from doing what I had to do?
Well, they didn't know who you were until after they stopped you. Then the bad guys start turning on each other.
Nikki! Sorry, Patsy. I'm with Mr. Fortune, too.
Well, how do you like that? My own brother.
Yeah, your own brother. You treated me like dirt. Besides, like Pop always said, stick with the money, Nikki.
Aw, brother against brother. How sad. Joey set up 5 bombs around the ship to take out all the other bad guys so he can be the head bad guy. Not a terrible plan, I suppose. One goes off quickly, 3 of them go off in 30 minutes, and the last one is in the room with the rest of them and will go off in 6 minutes. The remaining bad guys start panicking, but our heroes manage to get Patsy to let them go because they know a lot about bombs.
What are you talking about?
What we're talking about is police demolition and little things like impact switches, delayed fuses, directional fuses, pressure-sensitive detonators, trembler switches.
We're just saying words now! Meanwhile, Stafford discovers the captain dead and responds in an appropriately British fashion.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear.
Isn't it nice to see cops and criminals working together in harmony like this? They're not trying to defuse the bomb, just muffle the blast so it won't hurt them and we'll get them out of the room. I actually like that.
Okay, come on, come on, come on!
Move it, dummy! It works like a charm, but they're quickly thwarted by Stafford. Luckily, his budding love for Starsky convinces him to let the boys go so they can find the rest of the bombs.
What can I do?
I don't know.
That's such a great exchange.
Hey. See you around.
Short episode, but at least it was tight and action-packed, and it's not over yet, is it? Oh yeah, I guess they do have to track down Joey. Starsky, your shirt. Why? The Mexican authorities give the boys permission to tear through the countryside via dune buggy, I guess on account of the fact that they're stars of their own TV show. Meanwhile, Joey and his loyalists are making their getaway. Our heroes spot them quickly and take off after them.
I know this isn't the best time to talk about it, but what exactly did you do in Duluth?
That depends!
On what? The day of the week!
Like, Duluth is a pretty city and all, but not terribly exciting from what I remember. Why are we acting like Hutch grew up as some sort of Minnesotan daredevil? Hutch starts driving like a madman and Starsky starts screaming like a child. This goes on for approximately 8.5 years.
Surprise!
So finally, and I mean finally, Joey, Nikki, and What's-His-Face crash and the boys capture them. So after a very well done episode, we end with some more Hackensack hijinks. Yay.
I now take great pleasure as a newly appointed captain of this boat ship.
Aw, Stafford made captain. Good for him. Oh, excuse me, I stand corrected. We're ending with more Huggerini hijinks. Yay.
Ready. This is my big chance, Ma.
The view's better over here.
And so our episode ends with Huggy murdering Bertha. And then he went to prison along with the boys for not stopping this senseless killing. Seriously, what the crap, show? And that was Murder at Sea Part 2. And it's awesome. Whereas the first part meanders around a bit before they even get on the ship, this episode is focused and really exciting and pretty suspenseful on the first viewing. Sure, the bomb hunting goes on for quite a while, as does the dune buggy chase, but that just says to me that this didn't need to be a two-part episode. We could have cut out like 3/4 of the Hackensack stuff and just made a really good one-part episode. Still, the first part is charming in that love boat kind of way, and the second part is exciting, so I guess all in all, it works. Probably one of the better two-part episodes they did. This has been Fandom on Demand, bringing you fandom when you demand it.